Good morning, students. Today we are going to start our lesson number 3, that is making friends. So this lesson is about the friends, the family. So let us start the lesson. In 19th century New England, four sisters, the tomboyish Jo, the beautiful Meg, the frail Beth, and the curly haired Emmy. They are the four sisters, Jo, Meg, Beth, and Emmy. Grow up from girls into young women while their father is away at war. Means father is not at home, he is in army. Their family is poor but they are content and happy. Means the family is not rich, it is poor, but even then the children are contented. They are always willing to make friends and help others. Are the sisters able to make friends with a lonely neighbor? Read the dramatized version of an extract with Little Women, from Little Women. Now see the characters, Jo, Meg, and the March sister. Jo and Meg, they are the March sister, March family. Then Laurie, the boy in the neighborhood. Grandfather, Laurie's grandfather, old Mr. Lawrence. Maid, the helper in the Lawrence household. Now it is the dramatization, therefore the scene are there. So in the first scene, what is the setting in the first scene? See, the scene is set in the drawing room. The room has two sofas facing each other, two deep chairs, a cupboard, and a large coffee table. Between the sofa is the fireplace where a small cheerful fire is blazing, means it is going on. The sofas and chairs are covered with pretty but faded cloth. The cloth is pretty but it is faded, not very bright. The curtain at the window are crimson, bright one, now faded to a dull color. The effect is one of the shabby, grinted poverty. A young girl is reading on one of the sofas and her feet stretched towards the fire. This is Meg. Means the girl is sitting in the house and the condition of the house is not so good, means they are not rich, but it is neat and clean house. She looks up as other young girl walks in wearing rubber boots and hooded cape with a broom in her hand, and she shower in other. Meg, what in the world are you going to do now, Jo? Going out for some exercise, she smiles. Meg, horrified, exercise on a cold day like this? Means both the sisters are talking to each other. Jo, you can sit here and read Ivan Bo and toast your feet. I am going out. Jo exists. Left, Meg stares after her sisters. So the girl has gone out and one girl is sitting on the sofa and enjoying fire. Now see, these two girls are there. One is with broom and another is sitting on the sofa and enjoying the fire. And one is going out to take exercise. Meg. Jo shrugs her shoulders. She can never sit still for even a moment. But she will be back soon, complaining of the cold and telling me how her feet and ears and fingers are frozen and ready to drop off. So what happened that Jo refused, shrugs means moving the shoulders, and what she is saying that she always complained about the things, but she will never be able to enjoy the cold for a long time, and after some time she will come back complaining the cold, and then she will be ready to drop off. A little later, Jo enters with an excited look on her face. Jo, do you know where I am going now? Meg looks up, startled. Meg, oh, it's you, Jo, you startled me. What's the matter? It is too cold for you. Jo, not a bit. I have finished clearing the snow and swishing a path around the garden. So when Jo come inside, Meg thought that it was very cold, that's why she has come back. So she is asking about the matter, but Jo says, no, it's not that. I have finished the cleaning the snow. The snow was there and sweeping the path she has done means she has completed her work. Have you seen the Lawrence boy who lives in their stately mansion on the other side of the hedge? I wonder if he has gone away. Or maybe his grandpa does not know what is good for him and keeps him shut all the day. He needs somebody young and lively. I have a good mind to go over and tell the old gentleman so. So Jo has seen a boy, Lawrence boy, who lives near their house. He is quite alone and she wants to tell his grandfather that somebody must be there with a young boy to talk and to play with him. Now tomorrow we will start our scene 2 and up to here we have read today. You will find out the difficult word and you will write the meaning in your notebook.